Hello dear students, now we are going to start unit number 1, financial services. Under that, meaning of financial services. You know about the financial services. Here, services provided by the financial institutions like banking institutions, insurance institution. So they are providing the financial services to the various organization. That means the financial services. Here, the financial institution are providing the financial services to the various organization called as financial services. The term financial services can be defined as activities, benefits and satisfaction connected with the sale of money that offer to users and customers financial related values. Totally, the financial institutions are providing the various services like saving the money, and that money will be invested in the various sectors or various organization or various financial sectors. So the financial services, the financial institution also providing the advising services to the various organization and transferring the money from one place to another places and mobilization of the savings from the publics, and these savings will be transferred into the investments. That means the financial services. Totally, the financial services means the financial institutions are providing the various type of the financial services to the various organization. Vidyarthigale illi financial services anta helidre kelavondistu financial services galu hanakasige sambandhapattanta sangha samsthegalu en madutte antandre hanakasigalanna ಒಂದು ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಡೆಗೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ಸ್ ಗಳಿಂದ ಹಣವನ್ನ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಹಣವನ್ನ ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಗಳಾಗಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಗಳಾಗಿ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಅವರು ಹಣಕಾಸಿಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತ ವ್ಯವಹಾರಗಳನ್ನ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕ್ತೇವೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅಡ್ವೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್. ಅವರು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಗಳಿಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಡ್ವೈಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನ, ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಿರ್ಣಯಗಳನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಡ್ವೈಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಿನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ದ ಫಿನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೊಬಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಆಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್, ಮೊಬಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಮೊಬಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ದ ಮನಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಮನಿ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮನಿ ಟು ದಿ investments to various organization. That means mobilization and allocating savings. That savings will be moving to the various organization like investments. Next, the financial services can also be called financial intermediations. They are the middleman. The financial institutions are the middleman between the public and the organization, because they are collecting the amount from the public and they are investing that amount in the various organization. Here they are providing the various rate of interest to the publics for the purpose of the deposit or savings in that particular institution, and they are collecting the some various percentage of the interest from the organization for the purpose of the investing that amount in that various organization. So these financial institutions are the intermediations. That means the middleman between the public and the organization. Totally, the financial institutions are providing the financial services to the various organization called as financial services. Understood? The features of financial services. Dear students, the very important salient features are customer oriented, intangible, it is perishability, it is inseparability, it is fluctuation in demand, it is geographical dispersion, labor intensive, information based, require quality labors. See, the every financial organization having the different features. It is totally customer oriented, not to the organization oriented, because they are collecting the investment, they are collecting the savings from the customer, and that savings will be moving to the various organizations. So the features will be discussed in one by one in the next slide. Very important features of the financial services. First one is customer oriented. Dear students, the financial services are totally customer oriented, because if the customer is there, only the markets are open. If the customer is not there, the market will be closed. Therefore, the financial institutions are collecting the money from the customers. So these money will be moving to the investment, to the various organization. For collecting the savings, the financial institutions are providing the various demands and various benefits to the customers. From that, they are collecting the money from the customers, and these money will be invested in the various organizations. So here, financial services are customer oriented. The responsibility of the any financial service organizations to protect the customer interest. It is very important, not just in the banking and insurance services, but also in the other sectors also. So the customer is very important for the every financial institutions. Without customers, the financial institutions are not providing any services to the various organization, because the customers only savings their particular amount in that financial institutions. For that purposes, the financial institutions are providing the very high rate of interest on that savings, and they are collecting the high rate of interest from the various investments also. The next one is intangible. So intangible means we can't see, we can't touch. Totally it is a intangible in nature. See, the institution supplying a good image and confidence of clients, they may have not succeed. Thus, they have to focus on quality and innovativeness of their services to build their capabilities and gain the trust of the clients. So this is called as intangible. So intangible means they can't see, but they are providing the various good services to the various organizations. That means intangible. The services can't see, but they are providing that services to the customer as well as the organizations. Next one is perishabilities. Dear students, perishability means we can't store. The financial services, like any other services, can't be stored. They have to be supplied as required as by the customers. The providers of the financial services have to ensure a match between demand and the supply. When the demand is there, in that time only they are supplying that services. The services can't be stored, like producing the product. When the customers or the organization has demanded, in that time only the financial services are providing by the financial institutions. That means perishability. The next one is inseparability. Dear students, inseparability means at a time the services are provided by the financial institution. Here at a time means the functions of producing and supplying the financial services have to be performed in a simultaneously. This needs a perfect understanding between the financial services firm and their clients. It means when the demand is there, the services are provided immediately the financial institution. That means inseparabilities. Understood? Next feature is fluctuation in demand. Dear student, the fluctuation means changes or different types of the demands. So it is depending on the various organizations. It means the small organization and the big organization. The small organization needs very less financial services, and the big organization needs very high financial services. But the demand of the financial services is depending on the various financial institutions, like the different financial institution, like insurances, banking sectors, mutual funds, finances, and various are there. So it is totally depending on the categories of the financial services. For example, the life insurance do fluctuate the significantly according to the levels of general economic activities. Understood? So these factor puts extra pressure on the roles and functions of marketing of the insurances. And the banking sectors also, they are providing the various types of the services. So it is also depending on the demands of that particular bank services. Understood? And the next one is geographical dispersion. So the totally financial services is depending on the geographical dispersion, like the geographical areas, like local, or state wise, national wise, or international wise. So the financial services must have the appeal of wider application. See, these to ensure this, the service providing this organization must have massive branch network. Branch network means the local branches and the national branches and the international level of the branches. So that benefits of convenience are enjoyed by the various sectors or the various geographical dispersions. Understood? Next one is labor intensives. The labor intensive, it is very very important sectors, because the financial services sector is very highly labor intensive. It leads to increases the cost of production and consequently the price of financial products, because the high personal cost involved and to ensure the customer convenience, increased use of technology is being made. So totally the financial services are totally the labor intensive. Without labors, they can't providing any services to the various organizations. Understood? The next one is information based. So these financial institutions are providing the various advices to the various organization, and also they are providing the various information about the fundraisers or how to collect the funds and how to issue in the shares or how to issuing the debentures. The total information is provided by the financial institution. So totally it is the information based the services to the various organization, and it involves the creations, disseminations and use of the informations. And information is an essential component in the product of the financial services. Cost of processing information is quite relevant in the profitable production of financial services. So how to get the profits and how much cost is incurred in the manufacturing the product. So these are all the involved in the information based. Next, require quality labors. When the financial institutions are providing the financial services to the various organization, it leads to working as a technical and the technology works. For that purpose, they require the quality labors. It means skilled employees and technology oriented employees, because the financial services are providing the mobilization of funds from one place to another places through the technologies. So it requires the quality labors, like the computer skilled labors. Therefore the financial services are requiring the or recruiting the quality labors. So these are all the features of the financial services.